God bless you, son. Love you. Lord.
Bless you, Jesus.
Yeah, Lord, bless you.
I've come up here thinking they would use me down to do service and with the Lord's plans, I guess, and that's fine.
Praise God.
You know, I ask that you beg the Lord for me because he has to come down from me.
Oh, bless you, son.
I'm fully ready to preach his gospel, but it's got to come down from him.
Yeah.
And I much prefer that these other brothers over myself. Unless the Lord's blessing me, then I prefer me.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's the way it is. I told them that at New Hope last weekend.
That's what it is, man.
And if, you know, if I could be blessed to feel the things I felt at New Hope Church last weekend,
yes, indeed.
You know, it was wonderful down there. Yeah. I loved it. You could feel the Lord there. I felt the Lord here in the singing and in the prayer.
Been good.
And it just, his love amazes me that he could love such a thing as we are enough to send his only son down here to suffer those pains. Amen. That we grown and die on Mount Calvary.
Yeah.
For such an unworthy dog as you see standing here before you. People will say, well, why did he choose this and that? I don't know. It was good in his sight, and that's good enough.
That's it.
I don't wonder why he chose this and that. I'm just glad from time to time he blesses me that I feel he chose me.
Yeah.
How unworthy that I am, and yet he still chose me.
Bless you, Jesus.
You know, Christ came into this world and he was born as a little child in a body without sin, but it felt pain. Yeah. It felt pain. I believe it felt anger. I believe it felt joy, just like we do from time to time. And in the veins of that little child flowed my redemption back unto God.
Amen.
No other way.
No.
Nothing I could do, nothing nobody else could do, no other way but except in the blood of that little child.
Amen.
He grew up in this world and went about doing good. And they accused him of everything in the world.
Yeah.
Even when they nailed him to a cross, they nailed him beside thieves on each side of him to try to make him look guilty.
Yeah.
He was numbered with the transgressors there on Mount Calvary. But I can tell you that there was a river opened up there on Mount Calvary.
Yeah.
There's a river opened up there and it flowed down that cross.
Yeah.
It flowed down Mount Calvary. And I believe it's still flowing today.
Amen.
I believe that that river's still flowing today.
Yeah.
And from time to time, we're blessed to get just a little drink of it.
Yeah.
Just a little drink of that cool water.
Yeah.
And it makes us to rejoice because then we can feel him in our hearts. You know, when he brought the children of Israel up out of bondage and brought them into the wilderness, they'd become hungry from time to time. And he fed them there in the wilderness. He gave them water there in the wilderness when they would be without water. He would give them meat when they would be without meat. And when he brought us up out of bondage, out of the bondage of sin, by the transgressions of Adam, we fell unto sin and was bound. Just as if we were in hard bondage. We was in sin. Amen. And that is a bondage.
Yeah.
He brought us up out of that bondage. And when we hunger and thirst here in this world, when it pleases him from time to time, he gives us a little taste of that meat, gives us a little drink of cool water.
Yeah.
That helps us along our way. And I'm so thankful that that's the way it is.
Yeah.
I'm so thankful because we would forget.
Yeah.
Man is a forgetful and spiteful creature.
Amen.
And he would forget.
Yeah.
Sometimes I long and I wonder, did he really do anything for me?
Yeah.
Then, you know, I'm blessed to feel his sweet spirit and I could tell the whole world.
Praise God.
Standing on top of the capital of this nation. I love the Lord because he first loved me.
Yeah.
And he gave himself for me and I'm his. Yeah. And nothing in this world can separate me from the love of God. Not nothing. There's no army in this world. There's no devil, no angels of the devil that can ever separate me from the love of God.
Praise God.
And I'm thankful that it's that way.
Amen.
My mind is kind of drawn toward the Warch family down there. It's such a sweet family. I love Brother Robbie and him.
Yeah.
And I hope and pray that the Lord will bless them and be around and about them and comfort them. Because we're just men. We're poor comforters for one another. But when the Lord's there, there is comfort.
Yeah.
and there is rest.
Yes.
This little church right here in the little Max Creek Association of church houses around, I see rest when I come into it.
Amen.
It's a place of refuge.
Yeah.
Amen.
When they were blessed to look over and to gaze over into Canaan's sweet land, I believe from time to time we're blessed to peek over into that land.
Yeah.
And get just a little taste of what to come. I'm thankful at times that I believe the Lord's prepared a table, Mother Jerusalem's table, before me, and give me just a little taste of it. I love Him. If you don't bless me to preach tonight, I still love Him.
Yeah.
Because He's still God and He's worthy of our praise. I still look for Him to be here in the morning.
Yeah.
Are you looking for Him?
Yeah.
Because it says to those who look, He shall come the second time.
Yeah.
Unto salvation.
There you go.
I look for Him. Not because I want to, because I'm drawn to.
Yeah.
Because Christ loved. I didn't just wake up one day and say, well, I'm going to serve the Lord.
No.
That's not the way it happens.
Yeah.
I've heard Brother Brian say and speak on the draw part. The sword, it's drawn, but it's passing it. It has nothing to do with it. Mm-hmm. Just as when we were drawn. Jesus told him, said, I come not to do my will, but the will of the Father who sent me. And this is His will. He didn't leave us to wonder what God's will was now. He said, this is His will, that all that He has given me will come unto me.
Amen. Amen. Yeah.
That means everyone.
Yeah.
That means everyone
that
was given unto Christ will come unto me.
Yeah.
And that's comfort to me.
Yeah.
Don't have to worry. Don't have to worry about my children. If they was given unto God, they'll come unto me.
Amen.
I don't have to worry about my grandbaby though.
Amen.
If it was given unto God, it'll come unto it.
That's right.
And that's a sure thing. That's a promise that God has made us.
Yeah.
You know, when we die in this world, no matter how much our family loves us, if time stands, they'll forget us. People will forget where we're at. They'll forget us.
Yeah.
But I'm so thankful.
Lord, that's...
I'm so, so thankful that I've got a God in glory that will never, never forget where this dust lays.
Right.
They could take me and throw me in the ocean. Mm-hmm. It don't matter. My God knows where this body lays. They can bury me on a strip job 500 feet deep. Yeah. It'll not stop me from coming out when my Savior calls. Mm-hmm. It'll take the same sweet voice that woke me in Johnson City, Tennessee from a dead state in that hospital out there. He'll take that same sweet voice to bring me out of that grave. And I'll answer.
Amen.
He said, I'll call and you shall answer.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll answer.
Amen.
We'll come unto Him. And I believe, we used to sing a song here, I've heard it a few times, the joyous sound of awaking nations underground. I believe it'll be a joyous sound.
Amen.
You know, here in this life we're troubled with many things. We give up loved ones unto death. We lay them in their cold graves.
Yeah.
But that ain't the end of it.
No.
If that was the end of it, we'd be of most miserable, wouldn't we?
Yeah.
That's not the end of it. For my Lord's coming back one day, and He'll bring that sleeping dust out of the ground.
Amen.
And there'll be a family reunion to cap them all here on earth, honey.
Amen.
I believe we'll all come out of that grave of singing praises. I'm not blessed to sing real well in this world, but there's coming a day when my Lord will tune my tongue that I'll sing in a perfect manner. And I believe I'll start singing right down there in the dust of the ground.
Right.
I believe I'll come out there singing praises unto the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Amen.
The one that's coming back for what He bought and paid for on Mount Calvary.
Right.
You're a blood-bought people. Yeah. Raise your hands and praise the one that bought us back from the bondage of sin. Brought us out of that state of bondage, of death here in this world, into His lively hope. Yeah. He's worthy to be praised all the days of our lives. No matter what, He's blessed us so well here in this nation. I guess a lot of times we forget a lot of the blessings. I know I do. I forget to thank Him a lot of times. And I beg that He would forgive me for my many transgressions and times that I fall short. For He is everything. He is my life. He is my reason right now for being. He blesses me to move and to praise Him, and I'm so thankful for it. It comes down from God. It's like the wind. We can't tell where it comes from or where it goes, but we can sure feel the effects of it.
Yeah.
You know, I can tell you that I love the Lord, and it's because He first loved such an awful dog as I feel to be.
Yeah.
You know, it's, like I say, His love's amazing.
Yeah.
I've got two kids, and I couldn't let either one of them be harmed for everybody in this world. But the love of God is far beyond the love of man.
Amen.
He sent his son down here to be beaten, unmerciful, to hide stripped from his back.
Amen.
Sent him down here to be nailed onto a cross.
Amen.
And suspended between the heavens and the earth to bleed, groan, and die for such a thing as we are. It's amazing to me.
Amen.
I'm so thankful for his love. So very thankful. You know, I feel a lot of times that I don't know why that he could even think I'd be worthy for Christ to even set foot upon this filthy old earth, let alone suffer the things that he did for such a thing as I am. But I love him for it. He put in here a love. If you're born of Christ, you're born of love.
Amen.
Christ is love. Love brought him down here. Love took him through his life here. Love took him to Mount Calvary. Love brought him out of that tomb. And love will bring him back in the morning.
Amen.
He didn't come this morning. Maybe in the morning. I believe that whenever a child of promise, every hour of promise has come unto him, then he'll come back. I don't know when that'll be. I can't pick out God's children. And if you give me that far, I'd just mess it up. So I'm glad it's that way too. He knows them that are his.
Amen.
And he knows where the bodies lay from Abraham, from Adam and Eve, unto the last day of this world. He knows them that are his, and he knows where they're laid. We're in a secure place.
Amen.
We're told, you know, I'll read in there that he said to go and tell your friends what great things I, the Lord, have done for you. And I believe that that's what we try to do in the stand, is tell what great things that God has done. You see, he come unto me, and I feel to be one of the worst, just as the Apostle Paul, the chief of sinners. I can't think of nobody that was worse to take his name in vain and trample upon his mercies than I was. But he came unto me, and I couldn't even raise my legs. And he caused me to rejoice.
There you go.
He caused me to thank him and rejoice for the things he'd already done for me. He brought me up to walk again and to walk in the newness of life. I believe that he led me here to this little church for a purpose unto him. And I pray that the Lord will take me and use me in any way that praises his name. Whatever way that might be, I can tell you that I love him. If I die tonight, rejoice in the Lord that he's been as good to me as he has. Never look back and want me back here, because all there are here is trouble and sickness and worries in this old world.
Amen.
I look on ahead to a kingdom. A kingdom, I believe, it was prepared before the foundation of this world.
Yeah.
It's a kingdom not built with hands. It's built by God.
Amen.
Unto salvation forever.
Amen.
There'll be no pain up there. We'll never have to see another loved one laid in a casket. We'll never have to feel another pain. I heard a preacher say one time, get your tears over with here, because there'll not be none over there. And that's a happy thing, ain't it?
Amen.
There'll be no measurement of time. We could have been there 10 million years. There's no measurement of time. It don't matter. It's eternal. Man can't imagine eternity, because we're mortal and we're going to die. Man can't imagine eternity, something that never, ever, ever, ever is going to end. The joy in heaven is never, ever, ever going to end.
Praise God.
We'll be around that throne, praising God, and we'll be satisfied. I've thought about this a time or two. A few times in my life, I've been blessed to be satisfied, but then the troubles of the old world, just in a few minutes, we're not satisfied again. When my youngins were born, when I held my oldest son the first time, thought there was nothing else in this world I could ever need. I had my whole world right there. Nothing that this world could ever offer me again. I needed nothing in it. Just in a few minutes, I realized that baby's got to be fed. It's got to be clothed. It's got to be taken care of. So then you're not satisfied. You want those things for your children.
Right.
See, I've been blessed to feel satisfied like that twice. Yes. But just in a few minutes, the troubles of this old world come right back in. And we realize that, we need that.
There you go.
But there's coming a day when we'll be satisfied forever. and we'll never, ever, ever need anything again. It'll all be right there. We'll be happy.
Amen.
What a family reunion he'll be when we can see our mothers and daddies, our brothers and sisters that we've laid in those cold graves, come out there shouting praises unto the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I want to see this man called Jesus. I want to see him for me and not another. I want to see the man with the nail scars in his hands that hung there and bled, groaned, and died for me. I want to see him. I know I can't see him with these eyes, but I'll come out of that grave with a spiritual body that'll be likened unto his, and I can see him then.
Yeah.
A few times I've been blessed to dream that I could see him. I couldn't see his face, but I could see him, and it's so sweet to me when it comes that way. So many times I've watched it break daylight, and I wanted to see him coming in the eastern sky to know it was over and I was going home to be with the Lord.
Yeah.
That's where I want to be. My soul longs to be over there in heaven's land with Jesus Christ. It longs to be there. It was there one time. And it longs to go back. This old body is of this earth, and he'd like to live and stay here. But there's a part of me that wants to go on over yonder.
There you go. That's right.
And one day it will. We live in hope. Someday, that hope will be reality.
Amen.
And we'll be satisfied with the Lord. You can think about it, the satisfaction, something we'll never see here.
That's true.
But we'll see it in heaven. I'm thankful for that. I thank the Lord for what He blessed me to feel. Thank you for your kind attention. Pray for Brother Brian as he comes up here, because he's just a man. I hope and pray that Brother Brian is blessed just a little more than me, because I love to hear him. I love him. I believe he's my brother. I want to go home with him someday.
Amen.
I want to go home with him to be in heaven in immortal glory.
That's right.
I want to see my brother and my sisters up there shouting and praising God for what he's done. He made us here on this earth for his praise. That's what we're supposed to do. See, the children of Israel, they wouldn't let him go. There was a reason. The Bible tells us what it was. God hardened Pharaoh's heart. Every time, it would tell you, God hardened his heart. And there's a reason he done it. It was for praise. It was for God's glory. It's why he hardened Pharaoh's heart. Even after he released them and they went to the Red Sea, it wasn't over. No, he hardened Pharaoh's heart. Chased after him. Can you imagine rejoicing and praising of God when they were to walk upon dry ground when he parted the Red Sea? The soldiers came in behind him. And he closed it up on them. It was for his glory that was done. I love him today. Love him tomorrow. He's always loved us. Don't be afraid when you see one of your brothers or sisters out somewhere in the world to hug their neck. Tell them that you love them. Because we don't know before next meeting time, there may be some of us going up. So let's tell one another that we love them while they're still here. Let them know how you feel. Love every one of us. Love the Lord, and I love every one. We're tickled to death to see anyone come to visit and be with us. Love every one of us. Come ahead, Brother Brown.